In this video, I want to show you guys some of my tips and tricks for figuring out what the exact font is in another design. A perfect use case for this is when I just got an image texted to me and my client says, hey, can you match this font? And you have to try and figure out what it is. So I'm going to show you some of my favorite ways that I use and the methods that I use to figure out what different fonts are in a design. So let's go ahead and jump in. With the very first one that I use most often is called WhatTheFont. So if you just type in WhatTheFont, it'll redirect here to myfonts.com. They've got the WhatTheFont finder. So what you can do is copy that image or upload the image. I copied it from my messages app because my client texted it to me. I'll go ahead and paste it in here. And before it figures out what it is, it gives you these little handles here where you can make sure that it's just around the text that you want. So let's say you had a design that had multiple fonts in one. You could drag this around just to the first font you're trying to figure out. Once you get that where you want it, click Identify Font, and it'll do its magic and figure it out. Now, sometimes you might have to dig a little bit to find the right font. In this case, this is very close. We've got a very similar looking font, but you'll notice if we're trying to go exact here, let me just zoom in on my screen. You can see that my client spelled out where some of these stencil marks are. So if we're trying to get this exact, we better keep searching. So I'm gonna scroll down a little bit more. And as I search, you'll see there's a lot of very similar options, but sometimes you have to really dig and hunt for this. So I'm gonna go ahead and cheat because I already did this once. I'm going to go ahead and just open up the font that it found right here, which is it Acheris, Archeris, Acheris, whatever. I'm gonna click on it and you can see it's actually on sale, which is a bonus. So if I wanted to buy this font and use it commercially, it's $12.50 right now. So I can look at this and I can see this is a pretty close match. If I click in here, I can type in the word Han, and we can even make this a little bit bigger so I can see. This is very close. There's actually a couple extra stencil marks here. So it's not the exact match, but it's close. So that's one method that I use for identifying a font. The other thing we can do is jump into Photoshop, and I'm going to make a new file. And I've already got that image copied to my clipboard. So when you make a new file in Photoshop, you'll notice over here, the width and the height typically defaults to whatever's on your clipboard. So what I can do is just go ahead and click create. It doesn't really matter for this purpose. I'm just gonna paste this in here by hitting Command V on a Mac or Control V on a PC. I'll zoom in using my shortcut, which is spacebar and Command to turn this into a zoom tool. And what I'm gonna do now is go ahead and hit the letter M to get my marquee tool. Click and drag around this. And now what I can do is come up here to type and then come down to match font. So it's gonna work its magic from within Photoshop. Now the benefit to this is that it's going to be using the Adobe Typekit library. So all of these fonts, if you have the Adobe Creative Cloud subscription will be, I mean, technically you're paying for them with the subscription, but you know, air quote, free to you. So as we look through these, some of these options are better than others. But to be honest, I'm still not really seeing an exact match. So I'd have to dig a little bit deeper, but if I was in a pinch trying to get this done fast, I could try and click on one of these fonts, click okay, and then it's gonna match that font for me. So I'll hit the letter T to get my type tool. I'm just gonna click on my canvas and I'm gonna type in H-A-N, let's change the color. I'll just sample straight from this here. Scale it up a little bit, my shortcut Command T, and let's just see how this looks. This is very close. So this gets me in the ballpark. I'll go ahead and commit this text here and I'll turn off my image layer. And you can see this is in the ballpark. If I needed to actually go through and, you know, cut out parts of these letters here to make it match exactly, I could. It's a good base to start with. Or maybe if I was doing a web design and want all my titles to match, I could make it match there as well. So there's one method. So another thing we can do, I'm gonna turn this back on. I'm gonna clean this up a little bit just in case this helps. So I'm gonna get the lasso tool, the letter L. Click and drag around my arrows a little bit. Do a rough selection, not perfect. There we go, go around again, all right. And one more, and I'm just gonna use generative fill, which pops up here. And if you don't see that actually, we're gonna go to window and then we're come all the way down to contextual taskbar and make sure that's turned on. So now that I've got that on, I can click on generative fill. And instead of putting any prompts in here, I'm just gonna click generate and it's going to magically erase all of those red arrows for me. All right, that looks pretty great. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to, There's a lot of ways we could do this, but what I want to do is actually jump into Illustrator now and show you another method. So I'm going to hit my shortcut Command, Shift, and the number 4. And that turns into a crosshair where I can click and drag to take a screenshot of whatever's on my screen. So that's on a Mac. Now on a PC, you can use your print screen button to capture the entire window. What I'm going to do now is hold on the Control key and then let go, and it copies this to my clipboard. I can jump into Illustrator now and paste that image in. So I'm going to make a new file in Illustrator, and it doesn't really matter what size this is. Typically, I just use the letter size here. It's the default under print, and I change the orientation to landscape just because it's about the same size or same aspect ratio as a screen. It doesn't have to be perfect. Since we're working in Illustrator, it's all vector, so I'm not worried about it right now for this. So I'm going to paste that in by hitting Command V. And then what I'm going to do is, first of all, make sure that you and I are looking at the same screen. So I'm going to come down to Essentials Classic by clicking on this little icon on the top right. And then I'm going to click on Reset Essentials Classic. So hopefully you and I see the same thing. And then in the Properties window, I'm going to come down to Retype Beta. If you don't see that, you can come over to Window and then come down to Properties. Or you can also go to Type and then come down to Retype. Now we have two options. We can match the font or we can edit the text. So I suggest you try playing with both. We'll go ahead and click on edit text for right now. And what it's going to do is open up the Retype Beta window, and it's going to search for whatever it thinks is the best font match. So you can scroll down and see that none of these are truly an exact match. They're very close, but not perfect. And that's okay for now. I'll go ahead and click on this one right here, and it's going to convert the text to live text so we can edit it. Once it's loaded that font and ready to go, I can click Apply. I'll go ahead and click Exit. And now I can even close this window if I want to. And what it's done is it's made its best attempt at blurring the background and redoing the text in front of it. And now we have editable text. I can use my type tool to click in here and type anything I want. And I can even click in here, change the color to anything else that I want it to be, or even cut it and paste it somewhere else on my artboard. So now it's completely different and completely customizable. All right, so that's one way to work. Now, one other thing we could do to find what a font is, especially if you're looking at something on web design, is there are plugins that we can use and extensions on different browsers. So most of the time I'm using Safari or Chrome. For today, I'll just jump right into Safari because I already know it works in here for me. I'm gonna come up to Safari, Safari extensions. It'll open up my app window here on the Mac, and I'm going to search for WhatTheFont. And we can see right here, this is the one that I use a lot, WhatTheFont. And if I click open, I already have it on my machine, but you could install it first and then go ahead and come back into Safari. I'm going to come down to settings. And then over here in the extensions tab, I can see that I have WhatTheFont in here. I'll turn that on. And I have some settings here that I could change if I wanted to. But as soon as that's turned on, you'll notice in my browser window at the top, I have this little F and then the question mark icon. So I can click on that and I'll go ahead and allow it. And now any text that I click on shows me what the font is. So this is Helvetica. It shows me the family. It shows me the style, the weight, the size, the line height. Even the color hex code is there. So for example, if I wanted to copy this blue, I could double click on this color hex code. This is Helvetica. I could jump into my design software. Let's change this to Helvetica. And I can come over here and change the color, paste in that hex code, and now this should match with that exact same blue color. So now you can go to any website you want, turn on WhatTheFont. I'll always allow, that's fine. Always allow on every website. There we go. So now what I can do is with WhatTheFont turned on, this is Adobe Clean. That's Adobe Clean. So it looks like we have Adobe Clean, the font, on every single part of this website. What else could we look at? I don't know, maybe Nike.com. Let's just see what happens. We'll turn on WhatTheFont. This uses Helvetica. I'm seeing a trend, you guys. All right. So anyway, that's how you can figure out exactly what font is being used. And like I said earlier, sometimes it's close enough to use. Sometimes you might have to dig down a little bit deeper to really find the exact match, but hopefully those methods get you close enough to find the exact font that you're looking for. My name is Derek. Thanks for watching this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something new today. And also, if you're interested in learning more about graphic design, don't forget I have a bunch of different graphic design courses, graphic design bootcamp, some web design courses. There'll be links below. Hopefully I'll see you in one of those, and I hope you have an awesome day.